So we're at our church and we just planted 74 North Pole arborvitaes. Actually, yesterday is the day we did the project, and I could not be happier with how this project turned out. You guys might remember when we planted up the area in front of the front doors right down there, put some evergreens and some shrubs and some ground covers, also some bulbs which are just starting to pop through the ground. So it's really fun to see that come alive this spring. But when we were done with that project, we were looking over here and thinking, like, what can we plant here? There was nothing in this area, and it's kind of a narrow-ish flower bed. It starts off about 5 feet and it does flare out a little bit toward the end, but not much. And we wanted something that was uniform, low maintenance, and possibly year-round interest. The North Pole arborvitae is such a perfect choice, and we've had really good luck with ours. We have, you know, that hedge along our west side, and it's done beautifully. We're so happy with it. And they only grow about 3 to 5 feet wide, which is perfect. So it'll fit, like they'll all fit from its most narrow point all the way into where it's a little bit wider, which we'll go down and look at that area here when we're done, because I have to show you what came out of the last two holes we dug. So the project was actually, when we got here, I thought, okay, this is going to be a lot of work, you know, 74 holes. I mean, they're 3 gallon cans, so they could be bigger, but they also could be a lot smaller and easier. But Aaron brought our auger. So he bought a 9-inch power planter auger last year, and the appropriate drill to go with it. And he was able to make these holes so fast. And the thing is that 9-inch auger is about the same size as a 3-gallon can. And you do want the hole to be bigger than the can. But when you rock that auger back and forth in the hole, it kind of just creates this really nice wide tapered hole with really fluffy soil to backfill with and all the way around it. It was really perfect. And then I threw a little Biotone starter fertilizer in the hole, planted the arbs, and I think they've got all of the irrigation in place. So you'll know there's a lot of activity, you guys, a lot of cars on this road right in front of us. It's a really busy kind of thoroughfare, so sorry about that. But you can see the 1/2-inch tubing here, and then there's 2 2-gallon per hour emitters. There's one on each side of the root ball, and we're gonna have to do a little bit of work, like, you know, making sure that the water's reaching the root ball. Some areas of soil will need to be just kind of raked out so it doesn't, you know, taper backward. But those are all things that are really good to look for right after you're done running your drip. It's always good before you put mulch down to run that drip system a few times. See what the coverage is like, see how it's soaking in. Then you can make adjustments before the mulch goes down. I don't think I mentioned that these grow about 10 to 15 feet tall. So there'll be a beautiful green wall right here, because the view we have, this is typical of our area. We live in an agricultural community, so you see a lot of trucks and tractors and things like that. And while it's not horrible to look at, it's still going to be prettier to look at these instead of that. We spaced these 48 inches apart from each other because of their 3 to 5 foot spread. In the end, we would like them to be more of a hedge than anything else. And I think they'll get that big, at least, because they're going to get pretty much all day sun. There might be a little bit more shade up toward this side because we do have some trees overhead, but I think that they're gonna really like this spot. But I do wanna run down to the end and show you kind of what we did, because we curved the whole hedge to meet the shed. So as you get down this way, the land kind of, you can see the natural slope up, which this is where the irrigation is working beautifully, because you can see with that natural slope, it's putting the water right around the root ball of this plant. And it comes out at a slow enough pace to where most of it will soak in right to this area instead of entering, you know, the whole entire area around it. And then as we get this way, we have a little puppy in here, a little guard dog. Anyway, we stopped right here because of that piece of concrete, but this is what we found in the last two holes. This pile right here and that pile right up there. So somebody at some point had dumped extra asphalt into this area, probably thinking that it was never going to be planted up with something. And yeah, so I couldn't believe that it took, like, we got 72 holes done and they were easy to do. Then we got to the very last ones when we were kind of tired, and then we had to be prying out pieces of asphalt. But it was kind of satisfying at the same time. So I don't think I mentioned that these are a zone 3 through 7. So they're extremely winter hardy for those of you who live in colder areas. A really good choice to overwinter in containers if you're wanting an evergreen for containers for the winter time. Really great choice. And they are resistant to winter burn. And I know a lot of the older varieties of arborvitae tend to get that wind burn on one side, winter burn. And these are resistant to it. Ours have just performed so beautifully that I don't really have, like, I have a lot of good things to say about them and not any bad things to say about them at all. And ours have grown really quickly as well. One thing I would say about these is that I do think that they have a fairly shallow root system. So I think consistent water has been the key to our success with these. Having them on a drip system where you can run it as often as you need to. Like the first year we had ours in the ground, we ran the irrigation every single day. The second year, I think it was every day during the hot part of the summer, but every other day when it was cooler. Then last year it was every 3 days. So as they get more and more established, of course you can back off a little on the water, but I think in hot, dry areas, they just do better with more consistent moisture because their root systems don't go as deep as maybe some of your other evergreens that you can plant. But I love the smell of them. They're soft, like they're easy to work around. We need to go through and cut off all the tags still. But I think this whole area is gonna be awesome to watch grow and mature, especially once they get the mulch layer down, which will be probably in a little while after they let the drip run a little bit. Cause I can see like right here, I'm already seeing, see how that one's barely coming out while the one right next to it is just like pouring out. So those are all issues that we have to address before this thing is covered up in mulch. Cause we want to make sure that every one of these trees is getting what water it needs. So anyway, that's it for this video, but I do have one more thing to show you. So all of these arborvitaes, they're not going to be planted right here, but they are going on our property. So the 74 we just planted at the church, that's just the beginning.